Women's tights, the solution to all your PC problems. Okay, I'm building a custom PC and I'm super excited about it. And before I go too much further with the design side, I want to test how different coverings affect the airflow. So the two things that I want to understand are one, how different fan covers affect the airflow, and two, what is the best dust filter material? I've done a bit of research online. There are a few great videos on how people swear by tights or pantyhose for you guys in America, but they never really go into detail about what type of tights. So we've got different thicknesses, 20 denier, 40 denier, 60 denier, and denier is just the density of the nylon fibers in the tights. I made a simple test rig to carry out these experiments. Firstly, I got a lightweight transformer to take me from mains voltage to the 12 volts I needed for the fan. Then I got one of the 140mm fans I'm planning on using for the case. I 3D printed 5 fan grille designs to complete my first test. Next, I printed a custom fan duct to guide the air from the fan to the anemometer, which would then measure the airflow in cubic feet per minute. Simple as that, and I was ready to test.
Nice. So, I've been designing my new custom case, and I'm hoping it'll be really nice. I'm carving out of walnut, fitting LED lighting, adding a little bit of bronze details, and loads more. And I'm going for a kind of nature taking over technology vibe. And this has loads of extra details as well that I can cover in the future. So if it's of interest, I'll give you a proper tour once it's done. However, I got to the fans and it seemed a waste to just bung in a standard case fan and mesh. I wanted to do something a bit more stylish, but I also wanted to make sure that my designs didn't impact the airflow too much. So I designed a few simple examples to test. Firstly, there's a fine triangular grid. The triangles play on the design elements that I'm using in the main case. Secondly, there's one with larger holes. And thirdly, I thought it'd be cool if every single hole just twisted as it went, so you couldn't just see through the grill. So this one has a 30 degree twist on each hole. This one has a 60 degree twist. And this one really pushes the envelope with a 90 degree twist. Okay, this was fascinating and threw up some totally unexpected results. I first ran a control test with no fan to help benchmark the experiment, and that gave a throughput of 938 CFM on this setup. Then I ran the rest of the tests. The first two tests revealed how much the size of the hole impacted the airflow. There was quite an impact on the fine grill, but I was surprised at how little variation there was on the larger grill, given it had holes that were twice the size. I thought that there might have been more than a 3% improvement. And then it got really interesting. Adding a 30 degree twist to the holes radically improved the airflow. It was basically only 4.3% below having no grill at all. This is an amazing improvement. The 60 degree twist reduced it a bit more, but it was still way better than the 0 degree twists. And then finally, the 90 degree twist really started to restrict the flow and brought it way down to the level of the first two grill examples. This is a cool effect to observe. I've got a feeling this is linked to the angling of the airflow with the twist into a vortex pattern, much like the Dyson does. Whereas the straight grills would splay the air outwards towards the edges and create a lot of turbulence. But I'd love to hear anything that you think on this, and I can run further tests to see if we can understand more. I'm thinking it could be cool to run some smoke tests and we could actually see the turbulence. Anyway, let me know any ideas. Regardless of this, there was no real decision here. The larger grill with a 30 degree twist was the winner by a mile. So that's the approach I'm going with. Okay, this is a metal mesh used for PC case fans. The holes are pretty enormous. You can see why people complain about them. The dust is definitely going to get through those. As far as nylon's concerned, this is the only one I could find online, but it's very much more expensive than a pair of tights. It's not stretchy and only really comes in white that I could see anyway. But I kept seeing all these forum posts with blokes talking about how they like to borrow their wives' tights.
for improving their PC's airflow, of course. So I thought this could be awesome. I go through types like the USB consortium goes through confusing version numbers, and so it's effectively free for me. And if you're a bloke and you don't generally wear tights, then if you're nice to your wife, it can be free for you too. Anyway, this is great because cleaning my dust filters also becomes very easy because I can just chuck them in the washing machine. So let's test them out. What we have here for our test ranges from 10 denier, which has the biggest holes, all the way through to 40 denier. And they do go higher than this, maybe 60 or 100 denier, which is very thick. But I thought I'd stop at 40 because this is pretty thick as it is, hence the name opaque tights. Right, so let's get testing. I then proceeded to destroy a whole pile of tights with a pair of scissors and test each one multiple times to measure its airflow. Again, I'll skip this flurry of torn stockings and jump straight to the results, which again were really interesting. So here's the results. Everything here is measured as a percentage against the control that was no filter at all. And I tested four grades of tights and the professional PC fan nylon filter. I first tested the tights loosely fitted, and you can see that the 40 denier took a massive hit to airflow, dropping airflow by 61%. You'll note that when more tightly fitted, there was a bit of an improvement to only 39% reduction. But when you benchmark this against the professional stuff, it's only actually a 10% difference. But where it got really interesting was with the lower deniers. Firstly, there wasn't a huge difference between the 10, 15 and 20 deniers performance. And they actually outperformed the professional nylon by a decent margin. So immediately you can see that tightly stretched tights are a great solution.
There's one anomaly, which was the loose fit 15 denier, which had a strange drop in airflow. I tested and retested this outlier and it was consistent. I can't work out why this happened. You'll see the tight versions are pretty consistent in their gradient. I've got a hypothesis that there could be a difference in the elasticity of this particular brand. So I'll do some more testing to understand this between the different 15 denier tights. But that said, whether 10, 15 or 20 denier, they all perform great and very similar. There's obviously a sweet spot here between 1, stopping dust, 2, maintaining airflow, and 3, as a lesser factor, how strong or sturdy the material is. Given there's no massive difference, I'd recommend 20 denier. It's fine enough to catch the vast majority of dust particles, and it's a stronger material for the cost of just a few percentage points of airflow. So these filters do have an impact on airflow, as many videos point out, but it's not disastrous. Ultimately, it just comes down to a bit of a choice. You can just not have them and accept that you need to clean out the insides of your PC every few months, or you can include them. And personally, I'd rather have the extra time. One final test I wanted to do was to understand the impact of doubling up the tights. Lots of videos I saw just had someone pulling the sock of the tight over the fan and using it like this. I figured this was a bit limiting, as the double layer would likely reduce the airflow without catching any finer dust particles. And sure enough, this is what the results showed. On higher deniers, it hammered performance. It actually wasn't too bad on the less dense deniers like 15 and 10. In fact, 10 was still ahead of the professional stuff. However, there's no reason I can see to take this approach other than pure convenience. And I've got a solution at the end of the video to tackle this. So let's summarise everything. Grill design is key. I was surprised at how big a difference this made, not just the number and size of holes, which is fairly obvious, but the angle and curve of those holes make a big difference. Tights work great, really great actually, like better than the commercial alternatives great. I highly recommend this as an approach. In terms of denier, 20 denier seems to be the sweet spot between strength of material, filtering quality and airflow. So go for this if you want to try it. And finally, let's talk about the doubling up of tights that you see in many videos. My advice would be to avoid this.
It impacts airflow for no real performance benefit. But there was one final area that I thought needed a bit of thought. Whilst tights are great as a filter fabric, they are a bit clumsy to add and remove to your PC setup compared with the custom mesh filters. So I thought I'd try to fix that too. To solve that, I made this, a custom 3D printed cartridge to insert your tights mesh. This means you have the best of all worlds. I'll upload this to my site, so you're welcome to download it if that's helpful. And whilst this is designed for 140mm fans, just comment below if any other sizes would be helpful, and I can easily churn out whatever size you like. I've designed this parametrically, so it's a couple of clicks. Other than that, hopefully you found this useful, and let me know if I've missed anything or if you have any other ideas for tests. Now I just need to explain to my husband why the house is full of ripped pantyhose.